Hello friends, today we are going to see a new topic called discrete time signal processing. Let us see. Discrete time signal processing. So we see here that there is a type of processing on a different type of signal, or a very special type of signal, which we call discrete time signal. Let us first understand, what do you mean by discrete time signal? So discrete time signal are those signals which occurs at particular instant of time. For example, I have a sine wave which is varying with respect to a constant called n. So I write it sine of n, which is a function x of n. How will I plot this function? The function will be plotted as, on the x-axis we have the variable called n, on y-axis we have a function x of n. Then I'll go on putting the integer values of n as 0, 1, 2 and so on. When I put 0, it is sine 0. When I put 1 and so on, it will be start incrementing in a sinusoidal fashion, like this. So here I am purposefully not drawing a complete envelope, but a particular instant. So you can see here the sign is in a broken pieces. It shows that the sign exists, the function exists at this point and is not existing between anything. So I'll amplify this part. So you can see the amplified part as n x of n, and I'm going to amplify this. So the amplified part will be, I'm having one sample over here, I have another sample over here, I have another sample over here, another sample over here, and likewise. So here we call this as a sample. And you can see that the amplitude is non-zero over here and zero in between. I can't say it to be zero, rather it is not defined. So this area is called as not defined. Such signals are called as discrete time signals, where the time is broken into samples or pieces. Let us continue on the discussion on various types of discrete signal. The second type of discrete signal is impulse signal. Now an impulse signal is given as delta of n. N because we are looking for discrete impulse. This signal exists at n is equal to 0 alone, and is equal to 0 for n not equal to 0. How can I draw the signal? If I want to draw the signal comes as n on the x-axis, delta n, which is a function, on the y-axis. Then at n is equal to 0, the signal exists with the amplitude a. So a is the amplitude of the signal at n equals to 0 alone, and rest everywhere it is 0. The amplitude is 0. Now let us see one more standard signal, which is unit impulse signal. Unit impulse is a signal which has its amplitude as 1. For example, delta of n is equal to 1. Instead of a, I'm writing 1. A stands for any random amplitude a. 1 is specifically unit. It is 1 unit height. For n equals to 0 and is equal to 0 for n not equal to 0. So what is basic difference between impulse and unit impulse? Impulse signal have an height of a, or an amplitude of a, whereas unit impulse have an amplitude of 1 mandatorily. So this condition have to be mentioned, whether the impulse is a unit impulse or it's just an impulse. Next standard signal is step signal. We are talking about discrete signals. So next discrete signal I am taking is step signal. A step signal is denoted as u of n, which is equal to a for n greater than and equal to 0 and is equal to 0 for n less than 0. So a unit or a step signal can be drawn as n over here, u of n over here, and its height will be a for integer values of n greater than 0. So this is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and the height is a everywhere. And it's 0 below 0 value. So it is 0 over here, then 0 over here, 0 and 0 for minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4 and so on. So this signal is called as a step signal because it looks like a step. We jump from one point to another point. So that is a step. Let us take another signal which is called as unit step signal. Unit step signal is also denoted by u of n, but it is equal to 1 for n greater than equal to 0 and is equal to 0 for n less than 0. Same as that of unit impulse. Here the amplitude taken will be 1. So all the a's will be replaced by 1. So all a I will replace by 1 1 1 1 forever till infinity, from 0 to infinity. But it will be 0 for 0 to minus infinity. Okay. So I have not purposefully put an equal to sign over here because it is equal to over here. One condition cannot suffice with both the states. Hence, I have written less than, mandatorily less than, not equal to. Now, if we have seen that there are basic type of discrete time signals, how to work with these signals? So to work with this signal, we have to develop some type of system. So we will have a system to which I'll give the input as a discrete signal. An output will be a discrete signal. Such type of systems are called as discrete time systems, or short form as DT systems. So a system is called as discrete time system if its input and output are discrete time signals. Okay, so we will develop a system whose input will be discrete time and whose output will be discrete time. So here we can see, now we have switched from signals to systems. So now basically we were introducing ourselves to the signals. Now we are introducing ourselves to systems, a special type of systems which we called as a discrete time systems. So we are into DT systems. Now we will be only dealing with a very special type of systems which we called as linear time invariant systems. Short form of linear time invariant system is given as LTI systems. Okay, so we took L from here, we took T from here, and we took I from here. So the short form of linear time invariant system is LTI system. Now what is the speciality of linear time invariant system? There are two basic properties, or I can say two properties of LTI system. First is, it should possess linearity property, and second, it should possess time invariance. Now, what do you mean by linearity and what do you mean by time invariance? A system is called as a linear system if its output varies linearly with input. Okay, so I would asterisk and write, a system is called a linear system if the condition says if its output varies linearly with input. The best example of this property is resistor. If I consider a resistance then of some value R having current I and the voltage drop across it is V. Let us continue with our topic on systems. So, we were discussing about a resistance whose value is R. The current flowing through this resistance is I and the voltage drop across it is V. So, what is the relation between V and I? So, if I draw a graph of V versus I, or you can convert to I versus V, then you will get a linear characteristics, which means as the voltage increases, the current increases too, with a factor of R. So, we write V is equal to IR, or V varies proportionally or linearly with current I. This system is an example of a linear system. Here, the output we are saying is current I and the input is voltage V. So, if I change the input voltage or I start increasing or decreasing the voltage, it affects the current linearly. If I increase the voltage by 1 volt from 0 to 1 volt, then the current will go to 1 ampere, provided the resistance is of 1 ohm. So, this is how we show linearity. So, the best example for linear system is a resistance. So, I hope that you have understood that what do you mean by linear systems. Now, we will see an example of time varying or time invariant systems. For time invariancy, if I have a system, to this system I give an input at suppose time instance t is equal to t naught, and I get an output at the same instant of t is equal to t naught. Now I shift my time from t is equal to t naught to t is equal to t naught minus alpha, some constant value alpha, then my output should also shift by alpha value. I repeat, if I give an input at an instant t is equal to t naught, the system generates an output at the same instant t is equal to t naught. Now, if I shift my input from t is equal to t naught to t is equal to t naught minus alpha, then my output will also get shifted from t is equal to t naught to t is equal to t naught minus alpha. That means I don't see any shift in between input and output. For example, I give some input. Let us say that I have an amplifier. To this amplifier, I give an input of 3 volts today, and I get an amplified output of 3.7 volt, that is also today. So, my T becomes equals to today, and this T is also today. Now, after 1 hour, I take again and give an input of 4 volt. I give 4 volt, this is T is equal to today, whatever was the time when I did 3 volts, minus 1 hour, because I am delaying by 1 hour, and suppose I get output as 4.7 volt, that also T is equal to today minus 1 hour. So, this is called as time invariancy. I shifted my input by 1 hour, then my output will also get shifted by 1 hour. So this is called as time invariancy property. When I combine both linearity property and time invariancy property, then I get an LTI system, linear time invariant system. Thank you.